Welcome to this video. I'm Xinyi, and I'm here to discuss the three main reasons why we are investing in Chinese tech companies. So, let's dive in. The first reason to invest in China is the efforts it has put into R&D. Given the government's ambition in upgrading China into a tech powerhouse, China has been investing heavily in research and development over the past few years. China's R&D spending has been growing at 12% CAGR over the past 5 years and reached $456 billion in 2022, making it the second largest spender globally. Under the 14th five-year plan, the R&D spending will keep increasing at a minimum of 7% till 2025. With this vast capital inflow, China has almost tripled its patent filings from 2012 to 2021 and nurtured 21 among top 100 science and technology clusters of the world, same as the US. Top research talent pool, which was rated by Paper Citations, is also of similar size as the US, not to mention that they are producing the most STEM graduates of the world, 4.7 million annually. Based on ASPI's Critical Technology Tracker, these efforts have made them internationally competitive in various fields, such as artificial intelligence, 6G, batteries, photonic sensors, and so on. The steady inflow of capital and large talent pool make China an attractive destination for tech investors. The second reason why investing in China is its highly developed and complete industrial supply chain. China has established a comprehensive network of suppliers, manufacturers, and logistic infrastructure that greatly benefits the tech sector and other industries. By 2015, China has already 5 times the supplier base of Japan, 150 million factory workers, and more than transportation. This integrated supply chain provides cost advantages, efficient production capabilities, and shorter lead times. Moreover, China's position as the world's factory has allowed it to develop a deep understanding of manufacturing and assembly process, enabling companies to quickly adapt to market demands. Here, I would also like to quickly tap upon the aging problem that China is facing. In theory, it should increase the labor costs in China and hurt the manufacturing segment. Currently, the proportion of people over 65 in China rounds about 13.5%. For reference purposes, it's 22% in Germany, 17% in the US, 29% in Japan, but only 8% in Vietnam. By 2025, the aging population in China can reach 17 to 19%, which is comparable to the developed countries. In fact, aging population is one of the main reasons why China invests so heavily into R&D. To remain competitive on an international level, China has to rely more on innovation, which can improve productivity and help shift China's position up the value chain, from low-value-add manufacturing to high-value-add services and manufacturing. With potential mass deployment of computer vision, industrial robots, cobots, which is currently happening in China, labor productivity can be further improved and help them stay competitive, at least for quality goods manufacturing. At the same time, as discussed earlier, the comprehensive supply chain in China further reduces the manufacturing cost and is not replicable in the near term. Although its aging problem is severe, China has the opportunity to maneuver through it just like other countries has done in the past. The third reason to invest in China is its large market size. According to research done by CEPS, OECD, and PwC, China is predicted to become the world's largest economy by 2035, which is in line with the government's vision to push China into moderately developed countries by then. With a population of over 1.4 billion people, it represents a significant consumer base, creating immense opportunities for companies and investors. Based on McKinsey Global Institute, China's upper middle income class is rapidly expanding, and by 2030, roughly 400 million households will enter upper middle income group, creating a $5 trillion consumption growth opportunity over this decade. This massive domestic market allows Chinese companies for rapid commercialization and leaves them substantial room for growth. If we look at three factors altogether, China's capital investments in R&D drives up innovation, nurtures talents, and startups. The massive market size allows startups to grow big domestically, and the complete industrial supply chain helps tech firms reduce cost and thus improve competitiveness on an international level. They close up the loop and benefit the Chinese tech companies in general. In conclusion, investing in China offers tremendous opportunities despite current geopolitical tensions, government risks, and demographic changes such as aging population and the current high youth unemployment. We are aware of the risks involved in the investments and have included in our research processes as well as weekly monitoring to limit our exposure to these risks. At this moment, we believe that our investments, despite risks, offer attractive return profiles. With the 10x DNA funds, we cover all areas described above, currently with five different investments. We have Xilab and Baidu, which will benefit from the R&D investments, AI innovation to be the main driver for the upgrading supply chain. And we also have Qifu Technology and Finvolution to tap on the market size. Thank you for watching, and if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them below.